All right. Hey, everyone. How's everyone's evening? Awesome. Okay, cool. Guys, if you guys can turn on the camera, that would be great, right? I hate to talk to myself, right? And I hate to talk to a blank screen even. Okay. All right. So those of you who know me, I always love to talk to people who I can see. And yeah, let me know if you can hear me. Sorry, I have to just mute everybody for now, right? Just make sure that the background is not too noisy. Okay. But once again, if you can hear me, just type the word hi. Right, so let me see who is here. We have Poling, hi Poling. Sandy is here as well. Ming Chun, hello. We have Jenna and the boyfriend. Who else? Let me see. Hi Amanda, Chris, Daffodil, hello, hello. Right, awesome. Okay, so some of you just like messaged me about 10 minutes ago, so I was still sending, I was still PMing links of like 10 minutes before this. Okay, cool. So how do we want to do this AME? Is very straightforward. So if you guys have any question about cryptocurrency, okay, guys, how many of you have already set up the exchange account, be it Gemini or Binance? Can you type yes in the comment? How many of you have already set up an account and type in yes? I just want to know how many of you are already ready. Okay, so most of you are already ready. Okay, good. All right, let me just turn off the sound, right? Otherwise, I'll keep hearing ping, 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 ping. Okay, good. So most of you would have an exchange. Now, the key thing I want to highlight first is that the main thing you want to do is to make sure, right, it's a reliable exchange, okay? Because don't get me wrong, this whole thing about cryptocurrency is that there's still quite a bit of fraud going on. Right, there's still quite a bit of fraud ongoing, and you need to be aware, right, to make sure that the contracts that you go into, the blockchains that you go into to buy the Bitcoin is legitimate. Because ultimately, what is Bitcoin? Bitcoin is nothing more than a code, right, that kind of encrypt your information. But the strong thing about Bitcoin is that it's immutable. That means it cannot be removed. It cannot be changed. Right. In fact, how strong it has been 12 years, right? It started off in the early 2008, right? And this is the 12th year. Now, we have never seen Bitcoin itself being hacked, right? But of course, we have seen exchanges, the bank accounts that hold Bitcoin being hacked before. Okay, cool. All right, so let's start the AMA. There's about close to 40 of you here. Any questions you have about cryptocurrency, shoot, just go ahead and shoot, right? If no question, then we can call it off, right? Okay. All right, so any questions, just type in the chat. And yeah, and I want to bring you guys on to have a chat with you guys, because this is a small group, so I think it's no problem. All right, any questions? Let's see. All right, Chungking has Bitcoin in talk. Oh, I don't know talk actually. Okay, let's see. Let's bring up a few people then. Okay, Ming Chun, I mute you. Ming Chun, hello.
Hello, hello.
Hey,
hello.
How are you, man? Okay, so your question is what? Do I only invest in Bitcoin, is it?
Yep.
Kind of yes and no. The reason is because my main investment is in Bitcoin, right? It's the strongest cryptocurrency by far, the oldest, the one that has survived the longest. So definitely that is the main investment. But there are two types of what we call currency-backed cryptocurrency, which is USD Tether and USD Cash, which just recently got launched, right? So these are kind of like, you can call it US dollars, but in the cryptocurrency world, right? So sometimes I transit between these two when I do trades. Like for example, if I see Bitcoin spike up quite high, you know, I just want to get some profit, then I will exit it into a holding currency, which is US Cash or US Tether. Right. When I say US dollar cash, I don't mean the actual cash. It's actually let me type it in the chat. It's actually a kind of cryptocurrency itself. Okay, so let me just type it in. USDT and USDC. Now USDT, USDC, very similar. They kind of represent like every dollar of USDT is backed by a dollar of US dollars, right? So instead of cashing it out and then holding it in cash, I just hold it in USDT and USDC so that I can buy back into Bitcoin again when the price is better.
I see.
Can I ask you a question?
Yep. All right. Okay. Thank you.
All right. No problem. Okay. Let me see. What other questions you guys may have? Ah, okay. So, wow, I have no idea how to pronounce your name. Let's see. Huh? Okay. Yixiao. Sorry, I'm so sorry. Cheng Yixiao. Is it correct? Hello? Hey, Yixiao, I'm trying to unmute you. Can you talk? No, no. No. Okay, yes.
Hello, hi.
Hello, hi. Yes.
I was just asking about for cryptocurrency. I haven't started yet and I know very little about it.
Yeah.
I was just wondering if you were to purchase it via Gemini, for example,
yep.
is it a good idea to actually keep it on that platform? Because I understand that there's no holding fee, but I also have a little bit concerned about security of keeping it on the platform.
Of course. Okay, so very good question. So the simplest way to look at it, right, is that treat it like your actual cash. Right. So when you go to the money exchanger to exchange money, right, they will just give you physical cash. Now, you can either take that cash and hold it with the money exchanger and say, hey, when I need it, let me come back to you. Or you can say, no, let me keep it myself. Right. So it's exactly that. So for me, right, give me a second. So for me, for cryptocurrency, there's two pools of cryptocurrency in my investment. One is one that I used to trade. That one, I just hold it in the exchange because I want that flexibility of trading in and out, right? But those that I want to hold for very long term, so it's kind of like investing, right? If you want companies that you want to invest long term, then you buy and you hold in the account, right? If something that you want to trade, maybe you want to hold it in a different account. So if you want to buy and hold, then you can go and buy one of these, right? This is a ledger. I don't know if you can see it, right? I don't know whether there's a promo code that I can send you. Let me just check. But this thing is very cheap. This one costs you like maybe 100 plus, right? So this thing stores my long-term cryptocurrency, which is Bitcoin. Most of it is Bitcoin, right? Then the rest, I will just hold it in the exchange. But of course, once again, go with reliable exchange. The reliable ones that I can see so far definitely will be Coinbase. But I don't recommend buying from Coinbase, right? I don't mind use Coinbase to trade, but I wouldn't buy from Coinbase. So Coinbase, Gemini, Binance, these are the big guys, lah. Right. And I think Bitmain recently came out with this thing called MatrixPod. It's their version of Gemini, right? So these are the main players. Like Bitmain is the largest in China by far right now. Okay. So I hope I answered the question. Huh? Okay. So Andre is asking, is BTC going through a correction now? Okay, so the thing is this, actually BTC currently looks like, okay, so it's a bit of TA. Hey guys, those of you who don't know TA, don't be shy. Just say, don't know. Okay, just say don't know. So I can explain to you all a bit more. TA, by the way, is technical analysis. Hey, who doesn't understand TA one? Can you all be honest? Otherwise, I'll go very high level. Also, everyone understand? Okay, very good. So if you look at it right now, right? If you look at the TA side of the house. So let's zoom out 5 years, right? So you can see this is Bitcoin, right? And why I zoom out and I drew this, right? Because you can see that this was a very significant resistance level. So I wouldn't say at this point in time, Bitcoin is going down, right? It's going through a correction. In fact, it is climbing back up just like the stock market. Which is actually very unusual because most people expected Bitcoin to be kind of like inversely correlated to the stock market. Okay. But what we're seeing now is coming back up to a support level that's about 11650. Resistance level, right? Now it's about 1100 and 100. Okay. So potentially this could be a strong resistance level. No one knows for sure. In fact, it did bounce off a little bit, right? Then it came down, right? So that's what we are seeing right now. That time when it pierced up, I did sell a little bit, but once again, you always have two accounts, right? You have one that you buy and hold for longer term, one you do trading, right? So that's why I did. Okay, so yep. I hope I answered the question for Andre. Okay, so let me see who else is in the house. Sandy. Okay, let's talk to Sandy. Sandy.
Hello.
Hi, Sandy. Hello. Wow, long time no see, man.
Busy man with work, sorry.
No problem.
Yeah. Okay, what I was gonna ask. Yeah, how do we know what exchange is reliable? How do we determine?
Yeah. Okay, so very simple. It's like what Rudy has said before, right? You all watch Rudy's video, right? So a lot of times you need to look at who is behind the exchange, right? It must be someone that's reliable, that you can legitimately say that, you know, I kind of trust this guy, right? So if you look at Gemini, is the Winklevoss brothers. They are also the first few who tried to start a Bitcoin ETF. And this guy goes way back when Bitcoin first started. In fact, they are one of the largest holder. We call it the hodling group, right? HODL, hodling group, hodler, right? I would think the Winklevoss brother is one of the largest holder of Bitcoin right now, in excess of, I think, 5%, if I'm not wrong. The global supply, think about it. If you have global supply of money, 5%, that's crazy, right? So they have global supply of Bitcoin about 5%. So yeah, so these guys, I would say quite reliable. And then the next thing is you look behind the technology, right? Is the platform very clunky, right? That's one thing it's a sure red flag that you straight away you can tell already. The next thing is whether they are KYC AML, that means they are know your client, and then the anti-money laundering things are done very properly, right? So if you open Binance or you open Gemini, they will ask you like, you know, send us your IC, send out your proof of address. They will even ask you like, hey, can you take out your IC and then put in front and then take a picture, put a newspaper or something like that, right? So they demand a lot of verification from you, right? Usually the good ones, they will rely a lot. They'll demand a lot of verification. Whereas those that let you sign up very easily and then say, okay, done, you are clear to go, no need to verify you, no need to do anything, then that's problematic. Okay? So my last litmus test, right, is always how long has it been existing, right? So right now, I would say Coinbase is very reliable, one of the longest, right? Gemini as well. Binance, it has not been as long, but Binance has been very strong in terms of their tech. So if you look at the website, you know, Binance from China, right? So the website looks a bit China-y, right? Even the verification thing is like the puzzle to the hole, right? So it's a bit clicky in that sense. It looks like the Pinduoduo kind of app, but the tech behind Binance is quite strong. So for me, I just go with the big three lah. I mean, we're still waiting for the big four, but these are the big three. So Sandy, you do you have any Bitcoin investment or crypto investment? Oh, you mute yourself already. Let me find you again. Yes.
Yeah, okay, sorry, got the sound behind. Because recently I subscribed to this crypto.com exchange. I mean, also because of
MCO, is it?
Yes, that one.
Wow, I heard there's some saga going through MCO now.
Is it okay? I mean, I didn't put a lot of money lah, so I mean, it's that doesn't.
So apparently now MCO is trying to go for a swap.
Yeah, correct, to change to CRO, but
yeah.
I
but really I don't understand why lah. Okay, for those of you who don't know what we are saying, this is what I was saying.
this one.
So crypto.com is a Singapore? I don't know. Actually, I never do a very deep read lah. But basically, they did like this credit card thing.
Yeah, tell you Visa.
Then they attract you with like what free Spotify, free Netflix, that kind of shit, right?
Yes.
So the thing is this, guys. Treat Bitcoin or treat cryptocurrency, right, as a form of serious investment. That means it's like if someone asks you, do you want to buy gold bar? By the way, I will give you free Spotify. You won't be attracted, right? Because it doesn't make sense. But because now it's Bitcoin, right, then people kind of link Bitcoin to tech. Then they say, oh, you know, then they get a bit attracted to this kind of thing, right? So for me is treat your investment seriously, right? This kind of gimmicky stuff, try to avoid it, lah. And the thing is, one thing a lot of people did not go behind the scene of MCO, right, which is the cryptocurrency for crypto.com, is that they didn't even check like what is the tech behind it. You know, like what Rudy said before, right? You must look at the management, what's the technology behind, what's the use case behind it. So right now they are telling everybody, oh, we're going to expand the MCO functionality and represent it in a new way. So we're going to change the MCO to CRO. Like the thing is this, if your technology is working and functioning, why do you need to change? Like why? This is not like the UK or Thai baht where the king change, then you change the picture of the king, you know. Then you change, then you print more money to change the picture. You know? It's different. Eh? It could be a totally different process. But of course, they can explain, right? There's CRO and things like that. So So that's why I'm very cautious about non-Bitcoin cryptocurrencies, because there's so much of this kind of thing going on, right? And the truth is, when this kind of thing happens, there's literally no control for you. There's literally no way you can say, can I do something about it? No, right? It's either you swap or you totally don't make money. They even tell you already, crypto.com will no longer support these tokens. No crypto.com services or product will require and permit the usage of this token. Wow. So what happened if you forget to read this announcement? You're screwed. Right? So I don't quite like that. To me, Bitcoin, the cool thing is because it's so immutable, right? It will be here for a very long time. And we can go into the technology behind it and things like that. But yeah.
No question, right? Let's say if I have Bitcoin in this exchange now, right? Can I move my Bitcoin around different exchanges?
Can. So it's exactly like money, right? You can transfer from bank 1 to bank 2 to bank 3 to bank 4. So it's the same. You just need to transfer from address to address.
Okay.
And usually there's no fee at all. Yeah, usually there's no fee. In the future, there may be fees, but now there's no fee. Okay. Thanks, Andy.
Thank you.
All right, let me see. Okay, so TA, just now we talked about it already. So Christopher, we talked about TA already. So it's similar. Okay, so Cherry's asking how to fund a Gemini account. Okay, so just nice, I did a video. So tomorrow I'll post it. Then you can fund your account. But basically, you can just fund your account using any main bank account. Now, the key thing is this. You must register your bank account with Gemini first. Otherwise, anybody just send money to your Gemini account from any random bank, right? Gemini will reject it. So this is also another clue that this is a legitimate company, right? They don't take your money when they cannot verify where it is. That means their AML, the anti-money laundering, is quite strong. Okay? Patricia is asking, how is Binance different from Gemini? Just different company, different exchange. It's like asking what's the difference between New York Stock Exchange versus NASDAQ. It's just different company. Okay? So to me, is the convenient part of Binance Singapore is that the Binance Singapore, you can actually use USD to, SGD to buy the cryptocurrency directly. While Gemini, you have to use US dollars. Okay, so if you prefer to just use USD, then go ahead. But Binance uses Xfer. It's like a company in Singapore that does all the transfer for Binance, right? So that to me, that is like, I have to go through another third party, so I don't like, right? So for me, the simplest way is I just use like DBS Remit or whatever UOB Remit and get the best rate I can, right? And then just transfer in US dollars. That's the simplest. I don't have to go through a third party. I think Xfer also charges some fee, so I don't know. I have not tried using Xfer. Let me just type it in for you guys. I have not tried using Xfer to transfer money to Binance yet. So that's the part that I can't even type Xfer. Keep on auto-correcting. Wait. Xfer to Binance. May have fees lah. I'm not sure yet. Okay. May have fees. Okay. All right. What other question? So Ross TA. Okay, so we did TA already. Okay, so you want to see TA again? Let me see. What else can we see about TA? So right now I would say it's at a critical level. We want to make sure that it breaches this level as much as possible, right? But there's one thing that made me very convinced about Bitcoin, right? Is this thing called the BTC S2F. What's the chart? Okay. So you all can go and search this by yourself, right? It's called the BTC stock to flow chart. All right. So let me go geeky a bit, so you all don't mind me, right? So what is stock to flow? Stock to flow basically is what people use to use as a system to kind of measure how much gold will be worth, right? So the question has always been, hey, how come gold is the only metal, right, that is worth so much, right? How come gold is the only metal that is worth so much? Why not silver? Silver is also quite rare, right? You cannot just pick silver off the street, right? Then, and there are even rarer metals such as palladium, platinum, titanium. These are even more rare than gold. In fact, gold is actually not that rare. But why is gold the gold standard? Right, it's because of this thing called the stock to flow. Right, let me just type it in for you guys. So what is stock to flow? Stock to flow basically is telling you, let's say if there's 100 tons of gold, that's a stock, the holding stock, right? Each year, how much gold flow into the system and out of the system? And the theory is this, all right? And it's called the model, it's called the theory of scarcity, which is in order for this metal to be well used, right, as a whole of currency, right, it has to have a huge stock whereby every year the inflow, right, will not increase the total stock by too much. Right? That means when I put stock overflow, I will get a very low percentage. A stock to flow, I'll get a very high multiple. All right. So to give you a sense, right? If you put like copper, stock to flow is probably like 6 to 1 because copper is so used, right? Like, and it produced so fast, right? The stock compared to the flow in and out is very, very low. Right? Silver is around, I think, 12 to 18, right? So not too bad. But gold is by far the only metal with a stock to flow, that means the total amount compared to the flow going into the system and out of the system, as high as 66. That means every year the production of gold, right, hardly changes the total amount of gold. That's why gold as a quantity is very, very stable. Okay? And stock to flow has been used to model gold. And what this guy called Plan B, right, you can search him on Twitter, right? So what he did was, he tried to model it across Bitcoin, and he realized that Bitcoin follows the stock to flow model very, very closely, right? So if you look at this chart, right? Okay, so I think I'm a bit too technical already, but I hope y'all don't mind. Just look at the blue, the light blue color one. The light blue color is basically telling you if this thing behaves like a goal in terms of stock to flow, what should the prices look like? Okay, so this is the blue one. Okay, so you can see that it will go up based on how the stock to flow move. Okay, and then when he chart the price of cryptocurrency, which is this multiple rainbow color thing, right? The cool thing is he realized that somehow the Bitcoin prices follow very, very closely to that of the stock to flow of gold. Okay, so actually this has been widespread in the Twitter sphere among the cryptocurrency people, right, to say this might be a very good reason why Bitcoin can be a very good hold of value like a gold. Okay, so this is one of my main reasons, I would say, that I'm very confident about Bitcoin, because not just because it has lasted for 12 years and it cannot be hacked and things like that, right, is that there is a statistical mean to test the scarcity of Bitcoin. And we all know that Bitcoin at the end of the day, right? Guys, if you all know, at the end of the day, right, what is the maximum number of Bitcoin you can have in this world? Bitcoin, not other cryptocurrency, not Ethereum, not other things. Can you type in the comments? Do you all know? What's the maximum number you can have? Maximum. Max, Do you all know? 21 million. Okay? Very good. So in case you all don't know, just Google lah. Max number of BTC. Okay? 21 million. So eventually it will reach a max number. That means there will not be any more inflow. So what happened to stock to flow? The stock to flow will become almost infinite. All right? Almost infinite. Why I say almost is because maybe there's some Bitcoin that's lost along the way, but it will be infinite once it hits 21 million. And which is why this is also one of the key features of Bitcoin, why people love Bitcoin as a store of value, because they know that it is not like the US dollar or the Singapore dollar where the government can just keep on printing as they wish. All right, there is a finite amount of Bitcoin in the world, kind of like there is a finite amount of gold. Even though every year we dig out gold from the ground, but the flow of gold into the whole stock is so little, it's almost like the whole stock never move. Okay? So that's a very long way to answer a relatively simple question. Okay. Let me see. Yeah, so those of you with Bitcoin and other currency, feel free to transfer over to Binance. All right, so for Patricia's question, after besides opening Gemini, what else do we need to do? Actually, if you are not a trader like me, trade in and out, right? The simplest thing is after you open up Gemini, Then as and when you see that there's a dip in Bitcoin, you can just go in and buy a little bit. Now, I strongly encourage everybody to go through the whole process, right, of buying the Bitcoin, transferring into your wallet. There's two types of wallet. One is the electronic one on your phone, and then transfer into a hard wallet, right? Go through the whole process. It's like me telling you, you're touching money for the first time. You're a little kid, right? You have no concept of money. So how to teach the kid the concept of money? Very simple. Ask him go to the bank, withdraw the money, put it in the wallet, spend the money, use the money, and how he can earn the money. Then he will understand the concept of money. So it's the same for Bitcoin, right? Go ahead and buy some. Buy 1, 200. No, so you can buy as little as like, I think $50. I think that's the lowest. Or $10. I can't remember. Okay? Hey, but don't buy too little because the charges will kill you, right? You buy $10, the charges also $10. Then what's the point? Okay? So you buy about maybe $100, right? You take it out, put it into your soft wallet on your phone. Then you say, okay, now let me try transfer it to my hard wallet. Right? And then put it there for a few weeks. Then I say, okay, let me try to use it. Maybe I can spend it somehow, right? Take out the money, put in your soft, and then spend it. So that after this whole process, you will really understand the whole ins and outs on how cryptocurrency work, right? And you can even see, like, when you transfer that time, right, you can actually go to the Bitcoin main website and see that your transaction is being, like, processed, okay? All right, so Chuki's question, can I use DBS Remit? Yes, I use DBS Remit quite a lot. Any other question? Okay, so maybe let me talk to a few people. I keep talking to myself. Lee Quen. Is it Lee Quen? Hello, Lee Quen.
Hello.
Hello. Okay. So what's your question? What do you think of the conviction that you hit 100K this year? Who said that?
The Dr. Cameron.
oh, he said you'll reach 100K.
I think he based on some of the reports that he read.
Yeah. Yeah, so there's a lot of conversation going out there that, you know, because we just had a halving this year. So guys, for those of you who don't know what halving is, right? Halving is basically the amount of Bitcoin every year that goes into the market, every day that goes into the market, right? It's actually fixed. But about every 4 years or so, it will actually reduce by half. So actually a lot of people say that when the halving event happened, right? Do you remember what people, Lee Quen, do you remember what Dr. Clement said the Bitcoin prices will shoot to? Can't remember. She need to unmute herself. Okay. Do you remember?
I understand that when there's Bitcoin halving, the price will go up, is it?
Yeah, correct. So actually, if I remember correctly, that time, I only have 10 minutes left. Okay. Clement was saying that it will shoot to like 20K lah. But the thing is this, it didn't, right? So the thing is, I think nobody can accurately predict how far Bitcoin will go. It's just
he said the May halving, it will
we'll push it out to 20K or something like that, right? But it didn't, right? So the thing is this, we never know what can happen. We never know how the price will move, but we know what we are investing in, right? So if you're buying, so it's like buying stocks, right? If you're buying to a strong company, you don't know when Amazon will become $3,000, right? Nobody knew that it will be this year, right? But you know that you're buying into a good company called Amazon, right? So it's the same thing. So for me, Bitcoin is kind of like buying into a sound currency. I treat it just like gold, basically, right? I treat it as, you know, it's a digital gold, in my view, right? Because I really don't think it will become the payment source, the main payment source, because a Visa, I just tap my Visa card, it will transact already. Why do I want to use Bitcoin when it's so troublesome? Right? Doesn't make sense. Okay. Winston, how about Forsage? Well, I have no idea what Forsage is actually. okay. So CK is asking, there's a range of, hey guys, so sorry, I didn't use my paid account, so I only have 8 minutes left. So I'm gonna like breeze through all the questions, okay? Range of currency to buy, which one to consider. So the thing is this, go and do your research behind each of the cryptocurrency that you're interested in. And then ask yourself, is that something that you can understand and you can confidently purchase, right? Don't just buy because there's something there, right? There's probably like 1,001 cryptocurrency out there. You're not going to buy all of them, right? So for me, it's after I do all the research, it's like, I still think Bitcoin is the only one that I can confidently put my hand there and say, okay, I think this thing has a good chance of success, right? Okay, Ross, what is your usual take profit point? Okay, so it's a very technical thing. Usually at resistance, I'll take some profit. Okay? Cherry is asking, how about using 货币? Okay, so for those of you who don't know, China is very big in cryptocurrency because everybody there is trying to escape from the CCP control of their money, right? So Bitcoin is a very big thing. Cryptocurrency is a very big thing, but it also creates a lot of potential fraud or not, right? So 货币 is a very famous cryptocurrency exchange in China. I haven't used 货币 before, so I don't know. But in terms of wallet, right, I would say just use wallet that's provided by the exchange. Because if you already trust the exchange, then just use what the exchange gives you. Makes sense, right? You don't have to go and verify another wallet. Okay, so for example, Binance and Gemini, they have their own wallet as well that you can use. Okay, Patricia, very good question. Do we need to buy one Bitcoin as a whole? The answer is no, right? You can buy as small as 0.8 decimal place one Bitcoin. Okay, you can buy as little as that. All right, so you can literally buy like $10 if you want, but nobody's going to do that. Okay. And Andre, is Ethereum more stable than BTC? I think BTC is more stable, to be honest, right? Because Ethereum has a lot more functionality, right? For example, just now you saw the MCO by crypto.com, right? It's actually based on the technology of Ethereum, right? So the thing is this, when something is more flexible, it also opens it up to potentially more security risk. Right, it's just like if I give you a safe and there's no way to access it other than my thumbprint, you know that it's quite safe. But if I tell you that you can use thumbprint, you can use iris, you can use password, you can use another key, you can use a tap card, okay, then that means there's a lot more security risk in that sense. Okay, is there options for cryptocurrency? Yes, there's currently derivative coming up for cryptocurrency, especially from Bitmain, the China side, because they are very fast in all this. Okay. So polling question is something that I really cannot answer. I don't recommend anything, right? So I just tell you what I buy into. So basically, I have more conviction in BTC because after all my research, I still cannot find any other currency that gives me the level of conviction that BTC gives me. Okay? All right. So Li Quan is saying, can we leave it in the exchange? Yes, you can. You can totally leave your money in the exchange if you want to, right? But I wouldn't, okay? Because once again, your money is your money, right? No one cares about your money more than you. If you want to be ultimately very safe, this is perhaps the safest way to do it, really, right? Living in an exchange in the past had some issues. For example, Mt. Gox, right? There are some exchanges that was actually hacked. So what happens is, it's not that the Bitcoin got compromised, but the exchange got hacked. It's just like you put your money in a bank that no one knows, right? It's a third tier bank, and in the end, the bank got robbed. So you lose your money. All right, there's nothing wrong with the money. The money is still money, but the money is lost. Okay. All right. How many BTC should we have in order to trade? You can trade once again 0.0 to the 8 decimal place as little as you want. Okay, as little as you want. So BB, same reply to your question. Go and do the research, find out whether you can put your trust in them, right? I think the closest contender to BTC is actually Ethereum, but so far, I still not very convinced, to be honest. Okay. Okay. So, Cheng-Yi's question is BlockFi. Now, for BlockFi, right? You can put a bit to try, because BlockFi gives you quite a good interest for storing your Bitcoin with them, and in fact, it's way better than what a bank offers for your cash, right? But I personally didn't use BlockFi because I feel that by putting my Bitcoin there, once again, it's about risk, right? So I'm still need to do a bit of background check on BlockFi. But if I put my Bitcoin there and something goes wrong with Bitcoin, then that's it, you know. Sorry, something goes wrong with BlockFi, then that's it. So I don't feel that it is worth the risk for a 6% annual return to risk my Bitcoin. Does it make sense? Yeah? Okay. All right. Hey, cool. So actually, I think that's it. That's all the questions already. So Melvin's question about Talk. I have no idea what Talk is. Maybe I just go and search. What is Talk? Talk. Okay, it's a kind of cryptocurrency, right? Okay, so just need to do a lot of research into it. I'm not very sure what Talk does. Let me see. What is Talk? What is XTC? Okay, so maybe I share my screen with you all. Okay, I don't have 3 minutes left. So if I get cut off, then there'll be the end of session. Okay, so y'all don't be too surprised, okay? Wow, I searched talk STC, then give me ecstasy, you know? Okay, something is wrong. Let me see. Ah, okay, so guys, these are the telltale signs that you must watch. So for example, when they rebrand a previous cryptocurrency into a new currency called Talk, right? Do you see that? Rebranding of satellite to Talk. Then you know something is wrong. Like, freak, like, why do you need to rebrand your money? Like, US dollar will never rebrand themselves to like Canadian dollars, right? Doesn't make sense unless something very serious happened. Okay. So of course I haven't done enough research into Talk to say that it's 100% something is wrong, but these are the telltale signs. Okay, these are definitely the telltale signs. I don't like the fact that when people say, oh, you know, a certain thing didn't work, let me rebrand it. That is usually how scam kind of hide their tracks. Okay, all right. So for Chunkin, I will... Oh, DBS Remit. Okay, I think my video didn't go into DBS talking about funding Gemini, but it does show you what are the things to do before you put your Gemini into it. Okay, okay. So I think I have less than 1 minute. Okay, so guys, thanks for coming. If you have any more questions, put in the comments in the group. All right. I think most of you are in the Invest with Pete group. If you are not, do join my group, and I hope to exchange more ideas with you guys about cryptocurrency as well. Okay. All right. If not, thanks, guys. Have a great night, great evening. Bye bye.